Hi, I'm Tina, and I'm here today to talk a little bit about my mental health. I've spoken a lot about my physical health and my KAATSU bands, but today I'm going to talk about PTSD and how I feel like my KAATSU workouts have affected my mental health. I've been an athlete, been a worker outer my whole life, first a competitive swimmer, and just have stayed incredibly active. But about 6 years ago, my father passed away. He was just one of my best friends. Our relationship every day, we were close, talked, had coffee, went to the gym. And he was 77, and I was 49 years old. And losing your father is sad, but I look back now in perspective, because 1 year later, I lost my husband. And I was married to Tim Newman, who was a captain of the local I always, in my marriage, always felt so amazing to have a man that I felt so protected, someone who just had such unbelievable control of everything around us and the whole community. So he was definitely a big safety net for me. And before meeting Tim and marrying Tim, I would say my father was my safety net. So losing my dad, and then 1 year later losing Tim, that first year after Tim died, I just sort of had to figure out my life, sell my home, move. I kept working, which kept me distracted and busy in good ways. But after about a year of trying to go to some regular therapy, a client of mine recommended a special type of therapy called EMDR, which is used heavily with people who have PTSD. So PTSD, if you're not 100% sure what that is, it is post-traumatic stress disorder. And a lot of people that I've met say PTSD, that sounds like people who have been at war fighting and come home and they have so much trauma from what they've witnessed, either killing people in a battlefield or watching their good friend die in their arms. So what I've learned about PTSD is it can come on with witnessing an event, having someone you love close by die, things that are just horrible, tragic, sudden. They don't really even have to be. PTSD can come, I know from my childhood, now that I've done all this therapy and work, can come from moving. When I was 14 years old, my family moved to a city that was about 40 minutes away. That was traumatic, but in the world of PTSD, we call that a little trauma. There's little traumas and big traumas. Witnessing my husband's death, he died in 6 weeks of a neurological brain disorder, and it was horrific. He couldn't speak and he couldn't understand, and he would scream and yell and people had to hold him down. So the reason I dove into therapy is because what PTSD does is keeps you right there. It keeps you there. So instead of having beautiful and wonderful memories of my 9-year marriage and the fun that Tim and I shared with our two, he had two adult children, I did, and there was so many wonderful memories to be kept held close and think of, I couldn't get past that 6-week trauma. And it started to affect all the ways in my life that you operate, whether I'm gonna go to the grocery store or getting out in public, having someone approach me, asking me how Tim is. The thought of that was so scary. I had a friend after a year after Tim died who ended up at Hoag Hospital. I really wanted to go in the hospital and visit, but oh, could I walk through the door of that hospital? That's where my father died. Tim was treated there and he died. So my friend's maybe gonna die. So your mind just, with all the stress and the trauma it goes through, you really wanna work on understanding it and getting a grip on it. So from therapy to widow groups, retreats, finding tribes of people who were hurting like I was hurting, or actually trying to heal like I've been trying to heal, has been a crazy journey for me. It's been, I look back and I'm so happy about the different people I've met and people who are willing to sit and share their story with me, let me know I'm not alone in my trauma or my stress or my discomfort. And so I definitely have decided, with all my healing 4.5 years later, to try and be someone who reaches out to others. My local hospital did not have a healthy and strong grief group, so I helped reinvent that, and that's wonderful. That feels good, and it makes me feel like I'm honoring Tim. But what I really want to talk about is how my KAATSU bands have helped me, and because I was very incredibly surprised when I bought my KAATSU bands. I knew that they were going to help me with workouts. If I'm working and running around visiting family, and if I don't have a lot of time to work out, my KAATSU bands are perfect. I can get a great workout in 10 minutes. I love doing them on my work table, and I leave them by my bed and do them sometimes in the morning before I take clients. They just help with such grounding and clarity and relaxation. So when I started realizing that my KAATSU bands were having an effect on my mental state, not just my physical state, I got very excited. And I wanted to report that to the people who work at KAATSU. And I really want to share that with you guys, because when I go to therapy, whether it's $150 or $200 for one session, or my widow groups are not meeting for another month, I've got my bands, and it takes me 2 minutes to slide them on and hit the button. I'm loving the sleep cycle. And even before this interview, I was driving in the car and I decided I'm gonna plug in my bands and just really think about sitting here today and manifesting, and hope I can get a message across that, in case any of you listening have suffered a terrible loss, or which can mean a divorce or the end of a career or changing schools, if you've witnessed someone in your family, a loved one, a good friend become ill and you've helped them through it, there's so much to be done. You know, we finally are in a world where we can talk strongly about our mental health. Being an athlete, it's always been about my physical health, always. And what I'm finding with my healing, the more I dive into my healing, I go back to my past, and we were driven in my family. We were up at 4:30 in the morning, and it wasn't enough to go to workouts 2 times a day. We brought home gold medals, and then when that, sometimes a gold medal wasn't enough, being the fastest in the nation or in your county or whatever. So I come from a background heavily driven. So I watch myself now, and I try to move about in a much more mindful, slower fashion, which I feel like these KAATSU bands have been just the hugest blessing in my life. I might get a little bit OCD about them, and where are they? What room are they in? So my goal is to have, I live in a 4-story loft. My goal would be to have a set of KAATSU on every floor. But because when I'm just cooking or washing dishes, I love the feeling, the contracting, the buzzing. So today I really wanted to go above and beyond. I've noticed amazing muscle tone. I've noticed skin tightening. And most of all, I think the thing that makes me most happy is the grounding that my bands have given me, and that I've noticed with my mental state. So I can, I know ahead of time now when I'm going to be doing something that's going to cause anxiety, or whether I'm going to my tax guy, and because Tim was usually the person that did that for us. I bought a house. When I'm going something that takes great effort on my part and usually brings a lot of fear from losing my father and Tim, I'll put my bands on for about 10 minutes. And it's hard for me to explain why medically. I'm an esthetician, I'm not a doctor, so I don't know the ins and out of why they're able to do this for me, but I guess we do all understand what a good workout does, or getting outside, or a brisk walk, because I can honestly say that I need that. I need that for my serotonin. I need that for to have a healthier day, to feel, just to be gentle with myself. So, and it's really helped my sleeping, because I can get in bed and my head just goes a mile a minute, or I can go to sleep and then I wake up in the middle of the night. So I can honestly say, since I've been using my KAATSU and using it more diligently, because I'm recognizing a lot of different benefits, I just feel so much more relaxed. For me, that's huge. I would like to make sure I'm able to feel healthy that way, and I feel the more clear I become, the better I can assist someone else through their grief or through whatever it is they're going through. I'd like to be able to really help others, because when Tim died, I felt incredibly alone. I didn't know where to turn, and that took a while to find my footing, and once I did, the healing started taking place one day at a time. And here